What's up, Mercs? It's Joe here. Today we start our Let's Play of This War of Mine. This is a survival game that takes place in a besieged city. I have not really played much of it, I just learned the basics, so it's going to be mostly blind. Let's get right into it though. Let's go ahead for another try. Now, there is a little bit of an intro here. Let me just pause. Because there's a little bit of a cut there too. There is a little intro here. It doesn't really do anything. It kind of just pans over the shelter. So I'm just going to skip it so we can get right to our intro. This intro is different every time because we get new survivors every time. I believe you get 3 random survivors every time. How long has this siege lasted? It's hard to say when every day is a struggle for survival. The city is crawling with snipers. Shelling is an ordinary business almost every night. Phones don't work, there is a shortage of food and meds, and many people are left homeless. Bruno and Marco have always been good friends, so when the war broke out, they decided to stick together. They met Pavel while scavenging for supplies. He used to be Pogorin's star football player. Pogorin, that must be a city here. That must be the city, I wonder, or the school district, I don't know. Now he's just another homeless victim of war, so they teamed up, hoping for the best. So here we are, we have Pavel, who is a fast runner, he's slightly wounded. We have Bruno, who's a good cook, who's slightly sick. And Marco, who's a skilled scavenger. Ooh, that's really cool, actually. So the wounded isn't that bad, the sickness is. I'm gonna start scavenging here. It looks like Bruno has a slight fever, that's not good. Let's see, we got parts and electronic parts. We're just gonna go ahead and scavenge our little shelter as much as we can. Hopefully we can find some tools. That'd be really nice. Now everyone has a bio that I can read. I'm not going to read it just yet though. Let's see, we got wood, clean water, components, and herbs. And what do you have over here? I'm hoping for like a shovel. We have herbs, components, electric parts, and wood. Okay, I'm really hoping for like a shovel or something so we can start clearing out rubble. The only problem with clearing out rubble is it takes forever if we don't have a shovel. Is this locked? No, okay, good. More parts. That's good. Hopefully we can get enough parts to build either a crude stove or something to build a shovel with. Okay, it doesn't look like we got any tools. We got some herbs though for medicine, that's good. Some more parts, that's always good to see. No food though, that really sucks actually. Okay. So we could start clearing out some of the rubble. Looks like we scavenged everything we can without clearing out the rubble. Let's go ahead and bring Bruno down here. Let's see if we can't start making. I guess I can have one of these guys start breaking stuff down. Might as well. So we can make the metal workshop, and this is what you can make your tools with. So I'm going to start out with the metal workshop, and I'm just going to move it. We're going to put it right here, place that. He can build that, and Pavel, you can... Oh, wait. No, there's something to search down here. Marco, you go ahead and break that door down. You go over here and start clearing that rubble. So the good thing is I don't see any snow, so we did not start out in winter, which is a possibility. Now, that would suck if we started in winter. That would be such a horrible start. Let's see. We have more water, some more parts, and more electric parts. No tools, unfortunately, which really sucks. Let's go ahead and clear that rubble. So, with this, wait, whoops, wrong guy. Marco, clear that rubble. Oh my god. Okay, okay, I'm clicking buttons here. Bruno, you do this. There we go. So, we want a shovel. We cannot make a shovel. Oh no, this is a shovel. Okay, here we go. Let's go ahead and make one shovel. And while he makes that, I'm not gonna do this, because we'll have a shovel, so that doesn't matter. I'm gonna break this door down. Doesn't look like there's much in here except the medicine cabinet, which is empty, but we do need that medicine cabinet. You can, I guess, well, don't do anything yet. Once we get this shovel, everything will go much faster. Okay, now we have a shovel, so I'm pretty sure as long as we just go up to it, they will start using the shovel, which is good. Now we also want a crowbar so we can break down locked doors. Now, you can get a lockpick or a crowbar. The lockpick doesn't make any noise. This is something you want to use when you're scavenging, which I'll get into later. The crowbar makes noise, but it doesn't. It's not a one-time use. This is a one-time use. So I'm going to make the crowbar. This does break eventually, but it's not a one-time use. So I'm going to make that crowbar. And it really sucks if we don't have food. The first scavenge we're going to do, hopefully we'll get food. Let's go ahead and start digging some of these out. I don't know if they can use the shovel at the same time. It wouldn't make sense if they could. So I'm actually going to send you over here. Just in case the door is locked. You go ahead and try and do that. And once you get the crowbar. There you go. Now, is this locked? No. Okay. Then go ahead and break this down. Oh, much, much, much faster. This would have taken like a few minutes to do if it wasn't for the shovel. Which is very important because time is ticking down. And when nighttime comes, it's a whole different story. So go ahead and open that dresser. Let's see. Was that water? I think so. We have more parts and more herbs, which is always good. Now, I don't know how to use this. It says various herbs that can be used to make herbal medication and rolled up cigarettes, but... I don't know how to craft that. Here, you try and break that down because this guy already cleared it. Marco, go ahead and dig that out. Okay, whatever, Marco. Whatever. I see how it's going. Bruno, you go ahead and see what else you can make. Let's see. We can make a bed. Actually, no, we can't. We don't have enough components. Which really sucks. Okay. We don't really need a heater. We really need a bed, though. So hopefully we find components somewhere we really need a bed. We didn't find anything in here, which really sucks. But so be it. That is just the way of things. As soon as he finishes down there, we can do this. I'm not sure if we can do it simultaneously. I guess I should check, but I'm just going to guess we can't. Water, and what is this? Jewelry! Awesome! We can use that for trading later on. That is very good, actually. Maybe we can find someone to trade with to get food. Go ahead and do that. And you go ahead and start breaking down that door, and you... You really don't have much to do you? What can we do with this? Yeah, this is improved workshop. What can we do here? Is this just improving our things? Yeah, this is, we can make an improved metal workshop. A knife would be nice. We can use the crowbar and shovel as weapons, I think. I know the crowbar can be used as a weapon. Not sure about the shovel. It wouldn't surprise me if you could. It would make a little bit of sense. So you go up here and try and break into that. Now, here, let's try this. Can we do it at the same time? I don't think so. Nope. Okay. Makes sense. That's what I thought. We don't have two crowbars. All right, now. Yep, there you go. Break into what we got. We got a lockpick, which we can use when we're scavenging, a book, and we got some raw food. That kind of sucks, because we don't have anything to cook that with. So, can we make a stove? What does it need to make a stove? What do we need to make a stove? Let's see. Crude stove. We need more components. Okay. Now, nighttime is about to hit. I believe 7 o'clock is nighttime, so we're about to go outside. Yep, here it goes. And we just got this open. Medication. Perfect. That's what we needed. That's exactly what we needed. We needed food, too. But Bruno, go ahead and take this medicine. You are slightly sick. Get on that right now. Right now. You can try and dig through that. There's no way you're gonna have time, though. Come on, take that medicine. Hurry up. You need that right now. Quickly. Perfect. There we go. And here is the nighttime. So, we had to plan the night first. So there are four options. We can scavenge, guard, sleep, or sleep in bed. We do not have beds yet, so they're gonna have poor sleep. So, our skilled scavenger has 15 backpack space, so he will come out with us. Fast runner, I think, would be good on guard duty, and our cook, since he's sick, is going to sleep. He is wounded. Pavel is wounded. But sickness is a little bit worse, in my opinion. So there are three places right now that we can search. More come available as the days go on. So we have Shelled Cottage, which has lots of food. Lots of food, yes. Lots of food, huge amounts of materials, meds, weapons, lots of parts. There's no danger there. Here, this is food, meds, weapons, parts. Materials, weapons, parts. So Shelled Cottage looks like the best. This neighborhood recently got shelled and many houses are still burning. People were fleeing for their lives in a hurry, so we may find some useful stuff there without meeting anyone. I think this is a great first place, so let's go to the Shelled Cottage. Now we have to prepare by bringing some stuff. I think I'm going to bring all of our tools. Just in case. Lockpick for that silent, you know, picking. Crowbar for a weapon and shovel to dig through rubble. We can also use the crowbar to break down a door if there's no one there, so we don't need to waste this lockpick. Let's go ahead and scavenge. So something I noticed, kind of like Stalker, is whenever you're in a loading screen, the actual it will start a new window, which cuts out the DX story recordings. So if you guys wonder why it cuts off in loading screens, like I have to make a cut, that is because the game opens a new window for some reason. Or, I can't explain, it's really weird. So, here we go. We got a burning building. It looks like there's some bodies in there, too. Let's see what we can find out here first. Tons of components. Perfect. That's what we need. Some wood, too. That's great. What do we got here? We need to focus on food and components. Holy shit. Well, let's try and take some of this stuff. I'm not going to take all of it. I think that's good. Yeah. Let's go ahead and peek inside here. Nothing really in there, so let's go ahead and open the door. Now, if you saw those little red circles, that wasn't sound that someone was making. Footsteps, it was a rat, so we're okay. I saw the rat, it was out here. It's a little white rat. Oh, look at all this food, perfect. Tons of clean water and some sugar in here too. I'm actually gonna drop some of this wood so I can take this stuff. Because this is great. This is exactly what we need right now. We do need this water. I can carry this 10 stack there. There we go. Make sure you can stack everything you can. You gotta make sure to keep stacks. It's the most important thing. You can return to places, too. If we didn't fully loot this place, we can return. So, let's go ahead and finish that stack off. Let's go ahead and search the bed here. Looks like there's a basement, and there's something in the back? Oh, we got a bandage and herbal meds. I'm going to put the herbs back and get the bandage. This is basically like simple medication. That's what it says. It's a weaker antibiotic. We really should take this. Yeah, I'm going to. We're going to put the wood back and take those. Those are important. Especially since we have someone who's sick right now. And I'm going to go ahead and sprint. Because honestly, there is no one here that I can see. We would have seen footsteps like that. That is a rat, though. We got more components, more wood, so if we ever need any of that stuff, we can come right on back. Let's look through here. Nothing in there, so let's go ahead and let's break the door down. We're not going to worry about being quiet with a lockpick. Let's just break this sucker down. There we go. Open this up. What is this? One of the flyers dropped on the city. It reads, "This is a zone of anti-terrorist operation. Persons remaining in the city will be treated as terrorist supporters. For your own and your Wait, okay. Hold on. For your own and your family's safety, leave Pogorin? Okay, so Pogorin is the city's name. Immediately. The army guarantees you a safe passage. Not many believed them after the atrocities they had committed." I apologize. My reading. My Khajiitness from the lands of Skyrim come out. Okay, more wooden components, which is really good. We can use those later. So if we ever need wooden components, we can come back here. We have some roll-up cigarettes. We have a weapon part here. Book. Fertilizer. Wow, this is some really good stuff. I'm gonna leave all that there, though. Now, I'm pretty sure it is possible if we leave an area that someone could come here and inhabit the area after we've, you know, been through it. So we have to be careful on any return trips. But right now I'm just going to leave this stuff because I have a full inventory. I'm really just looking for an essential thing, maybe a gun. Guns are very rare. Ammo is extremely rare. Maybe I can find one. I'm just kind of looking for essential stuff right now. We have everything we need in our inventory. More weapon parts. Now we can make guns with those weapon parts. It is true. We have coffee here. We might have a coffee drinker back at home. That's why I should have checked the bios. Do you have a coffee drinking? No. Sometimes if they have little additional, I guess, I don't want to say skills because it's not really a skill. I guess conditions, it'll pop up underneath in yellow, yellowish orange kind of. And it'll tell you about it, like coffee drinkers or cigarette smokers or something like that. So let's go ahead and open this up. Looks like a coffin, honestly. More wood. Let's go ahead and dig through this, and then let's get this open, see what we find in there. And then I think we are good to go. Now, this isn't the only thing that happens at nighttime. Our shelter could be attacked. That's why you leave someone on guard. We will see what happened when we get back. I mean, We could have lost someone in a gunfight. We could have lost someone in a fist fight. We had to check. If the night could have been calm, I'm hoping it was calm. This is our first night. Hopefully it was a calm night. Let's see what we get in here. Come on. Ooh, what is that? A cigarette. We have medication. Small casings. Or small shell casings. Ammunition. Moonshine. Gunpowder. Okay. We don't have a gun. I'm not going to take the ammunition. Keep in mind that it's here, though. That's very important. And we have actual medicine. We're going to take that instead of the herbal stuff. And we're going to leave. We can just click run to exit and he'll go right out. We did find everything we could there. We just couldn't take everything we could. We have a full inventory, though. We have tons of good stuff. Food, material. And there's a little cut there. Probably cut me right off. I completely forgot. I apologize. So let's go see the report of the night. The night was calm. Marco had been searching for supplies and brought back some interesting things. Good job, Marco. So, let's go ahead and check Marco. He is hungry and tired. Bruno slept poorly and is hungry. He slept poorly because he had to sleep on the floor. He's a smoker. Okay, I was wrong. It pops up here, not down here. So, he's a smoker. He wants cigarettes. He's going to get a little bit depressed if he doesn't have those. And you don't have any conditions. You are still slightly wounded and you are tired because you didn't sleep. Everyone's hungry, though. So, what we're going to do first is we're going to build some beds. How many can we make? Let's make at least maybe one or two. While he does that, let's go ahead and try and make a stove, because that is important too. Let's see. Crude stove. Can we not make it? Oh, we don't have the components. Wait. No, can we cancel? I don't know how to cancel. Oh, man. If I would have known. Oh, that's okay. We can get the components next time. Now, we do have some vegetables that we can eat. We can eat the raw meat, but that isn't advisable because it's raw, and that sounds disgusting, and he'll probably get sick. By the way, Bruno is no longer sick, which is very good. So let's see what else we can make here. We did get quite a few things. We can make a radio, which this gives us updates on the outside. I think I'm going to make one just because we know where tons of components are. What can we make here? Can we make the knife? No. We're going to make the radio. This will also help morale. This will make people happy. So I guess I'll put it down where the beds are going to be. Yeah, let's place it down there. So we have one bed, which is good. You are slightly wounded and tired, so you will sleep first in that bed. They can sleep during the day, and as you can see, he's recovering from his wound. They can actually just get that tired debuff gone if they sleep during the day, and I can, if I pay close enough attention to Pavel, I can get Marco sleeping in there, and that would be really nice, but I have to pay attention, because, you know, gotta make sure that as soon as he's not tired anymore, I get someone else in there. It'd be really nice to send Marco out again on scavenging missions, because he has the biggest inventory space. So let's go ahead and check the radio here. The rebel leader instructed us to warn the listeners not to cross the front line. Failure to comply could result in death. Day 2. The rebel leader instructed us to warn the... Those are just notes. Okay, gotcha. Oh, look at this! Holy shit. I didn't know you could do this. This is cool. Let's tune it, see if we can find you. So classical music. Here we go. The upcoming days should be nice and warm, perfect for a stroll in the park. Good, that's good. I do like to see that. There's more classical music. Is this, what is that? That is the rebel. Okay, we'll keep it tuned to the rebel frequency. That's probably the best thing. Or it's city today, so that's basically our news station. He's complaining that he doesn't have cigarettes, but that is okay, dude. Well, no, it's not. Deal with it. I'm sorry. Break this door down. Hopefully we can find something good in here. Maybe something to build the crude stove. That'd be great. Who knows? We really need to cook that meat, though. What do we got? We have bandages, more meat, herbs, clean water, books, lockpick. That's actually some pretty good stuff. Nothing to cook the stove, though. That sucks. Okay. I'm pretty sure you can't build the next bed. I'm actually going to make him eat. Now, if you see, I fed him vegetables and says still hungry. He is slightly fed now, though, so he should be okay for another day, hopefully. I don't want to eat the raw meat. I feel like that would make us sick. That sounds horrible. I don't want to make people sick. So next time we're going to focus on trying to get some components and stuff. Let's see what we need. I really wish there was like a notebook I can bring up in this game. So we need components, definitely, for sure. I believe when you actually get the crude stove, you need water. Yeah, you need fuel and need water. We can make fuel out of wood, though, and books. But you need water to, like, boil it, I guess. I don't know. You need clean water to cook. I think as you upgrade the stove, it gets more efficient on its water usage. I'm pretty sure that's how it works, which is really good, actually. So, how do I make herbal medicine? How are you doing? You're still tired. Tired. Slept poorly. You're not tired, though. Nothing really you guys can do. I can end the day early if we have nothing to do. That isn't the best thing to do, though. Not in my opinion. We want to do as much as we can. I'm trying to see if there's anything else we missed out on. Let's go see what we need for the bed. I almost forgot. Okay, so components. We just need tons of components. So next time we go out, we get a little wood and tons of components. If I don't like any of the new locations we get, I'm just going to go straight for the old place. Now, Pavel is no longer tired, so we're going to get Marco in the bed. And Pavel, I guess, you can go sit in the chair. I'm pretty sure you guys sit in chairs. They actually feel a little bit better than just standing around. I think that makes their tiredness go down slower or go up slower, I guess. So let's go ahead. Can you make another chair? No, we need more components. God. Components. Everything is components. I kind of want to eat the raw meat, but I don't want to lose them. I'm not going to take a chance. I don't know what happens if I eat the raw meat. Let me check it real quick. It's edible, but would be more nutritious. It doesn't say anything about getting sick. So something interesting over here is some thoughts. This is basically the general consensus of what we need. Fortunately, our shelter is a place where we can come and get some respite from the war. We only have one chair. We have one bed, but we could use more. It's hard to get a good night's sleep on hard, cold concrete. We've made a radio, and we like listening to it. We have a few books. A good book helps forget the horrors of war. Staying here offers slight respite in these hard times. We lack cigarettes. We have breaches in the walls. Our shelter is not safe, and we have to be constantly on guard. Okay. Now, there is a way you can upgrade your shelter. I think you need to upgrade this first, though. The workshop, which needs fucking components. We're gonna have to get components. Like, it's the main thing next time. So I'm gonna end the day right now. Because everyone who needs me in bed is in bed, and everything is perfectly how I want it. Now, he's still tired, but I'm gonna put him on scavenge anyway. You slept poorly last night. So you're going to sleep in the bed, and you'll be on guard, Pavel. We need someone on guard. So we have two new places. Oh, wait, no. One. Oh, yeah, two. St. Mary's. We have the garage. Lots of food, huge amounts of materials, some meds, lots of parts, possible trade, caution advised. Then we have St. Mary's. We have food, materials, meds, parts, caution advised. So we could go to the garage, and there might be someone to trade with. We could go to the garage, and there might be someone who wants to shoot us. I don't know. I'm thinking about playing it safe and just going right back to the shelled cottage and getting tons of stuff. In fact, I'm going to do that. And we already cleared out. I'm going to bring the crowbar just in case we need a weapon. That's about it. Let's go. I'm going to play it safe the second night. Maybe next time we'll go to the garage. Sorry, I cut out again. I keep forgetting that in load screens it cuts out. But for now, we're going to take it safe. So we need components more than anything. I'm going to grab a little bit of wood here, just two stacks. But everything else is going to be components at this point. Let's just be as fast as we can. What do we got in the fridge? I can't remember. Was there more food than we left? We have water. That's what we need. Components. We're going to fill up completely on components. There's sugar. Oh, no, I want sugar. We can use sugar for moonshine, I believe. And moonshine, I think we can get drunk off it and get happy. Or we can sell it and get stuff. Herbs, no. Let's go down here, actually. Because I'm pretty sure this is where the bullets were. Now, we don't have any guns, but I do want to have the bullets. Because those are really rare. I'm going to get the moonshine, too, because that's good to trade. And a cigarette, herbal meds, shell casings. We can use both of these to make stuff, so I'm going to get those. I'm going to grab all this stuff. I still need more components, though. I might actually start dropping stuff just to get more components. And I know there's tons upstairs, I think. I know there's tons more than my whole inventory can fit in this house. Yeah, here we go. One water, is that worth it? I'm going to take the herbal meds out for four more components. There we go. Take some of the wood out for four more components. And I think that's good. So we're going to run to the exit. That is enough components for now. We have three bullets. That doesn't sound like much, but that could kill someone. So let's see. Did we get attacked last night? That is the question. Take a swig of my water. Alright, day three. How's it going back at the shelter? A little bit nervous. We've been raided. Someone came at night to take our things by force. Oh, man. We were attacked at night. Okay, so, yeah, he went searching. Someone tried to rob us. They didn't seem very determined, so we managed to fend them off. We had some weapons, but not enough for everyone. Bruno was wounded, but the attackers didn't steal anything. We were able to defend ourselves. Bruno got slightly wounded. That is not as bad as it could have been. Let me just check. Bruno, how slightly wounded are you? Okay, good. You're not bleeding or anything, which is good. So I'm going to go ahead and we're going to get these beds made ASAP. Let's go ahead and build another bed down here. And then we want a stove. In fact, we should really upgrade the workshop too. We need a lot of stuff just getting made here. Alright, let's get a stove. I'm going to put this in the kitchen. And then Bruno, you can go and maybe upgrade the workshop. Let me see. No, we need more wood. Fuck. Okay. What else can we make? Nothing. But we can make fuel. That's good. Okay, we make another radio, but pff, who needs that? What about this? Nothing. What about this? No, we need more wood. And lots more components. Okay. That's okay, though, because now we have another bed, another stove, or a stove. What is this? What is this? I don't know what that is. I don't remember picking it up. I don't see it in here. Is that the moonshine? I think that's the moonshine. It's a different symbol. I think it's moonshine, though. Okay, so as soon as the bed is done, we're gonna put them to sleep. I'm gonna make him go sit down up here. Can we make some food here? Okay, we need fuel, I think, right? Yeah, we need fuel to make this, so we can use the books, we can use the wood. We need to make two, so I'm gonna make one with the components. Which, you know, I do need those components, but I'm going to make one with the wood, because we only have one plank left. And then we make two with the books. And you are slightly wounded and tired. You go have a sleep there. And you're very tired. We're going to have to feed everyone. Let's make two with the books. And that should be enough to start getting, I think, four of our meat cooked, which is good. I don't know if we have enough water to cook it all. We'll have to see. You're slightly wounded. Do you need bandages, maybe? I think bandages are just for bleeding. So now we can actually cook food. This requires vegetables. This is, what's the difference here? I guess that's just double. Needs vegetables. Okay. So we make two food because we don't have as much. Well, oh no, it's not the water. It's the fuel again. Well, okay, let's just make two. Let's make two cooked food real quick. So one, two, there, boom. Cook those up. Someone's at the door. Oh shit. That scares me. I have some stuff to exchange. Hello. You're kind of scaring me here, buddy. Hi. Okay, we have a trader. Nice. Okay, so he has fuel and Ooh, weapon parts, and we have coffee and cigarettes, and... okay, so... Let's give you some moonshine. What do you want for this? And we have jewelry, too, so that's good. We want all your fuel. We have to try harder, so there. We'll give you a gem. It's very generous of you, so that sounds like... we're giving a little bit too much, so I want some water. Okay, now it's getting a little... Okay, there we go. We just went over the edge again. You can have some herbs. Yeah, there you go. Have some more herbs. Generous again. Okay, take some water. What is this? Tobacco? We don't need that. I do want the meat, though. I'm gonna take all your meat. Now, he is getting a little bit frustrated. You've gotta be kidding me. Show me some more. Have a cigarette and not the medicine. Thanks. Have more herbs. Have a lockpick? No. We might have to reduce some of the stuff that we're getting from him. I want some components, actually. We don't need all this fuel. And all this meat. This meat is what's really putting us over. We have tons of meat. So let's get as many components as we can. I would really like... And some more wood. Oh, wow. He's kidding. Where's the wood? There it is. We have to try harder for this one. What else do I want? Let me just see. We don't need bandages or anything like that. He has ammo. We don't really need that. I do want the wood. I'll put some of the fuel back. There we go. So we have a deal. We can give him some electronic parts and then get more wood. There we go. Still generous. Take one back? Yeah. What if I take both back? Okay, no, he wouldn't like that at all. So we do want to give one deal. And we can trade again. So now we can go ahead and reset. What about some sugar? You want some sugar? Sugar good? Very common stuff, not very interesting. So we can look here at the top. Nothing special, but not bad either. So parts are good. Books are not very good. Fuel, not very good. Ammo is really nothing special. I guess weapons would be better. Crowbars are interesting, and so are shut so tools. Okay. He actually are he's in need of bandages. So I'm gonna give him one bandage. Just one. Just one. And I want to take your food. I don't want your tobacco. Wow, food is. Food is really expensive. Wait, really? Okay. More fuel? Just, yep, okay. If I reduce this just a little bit, just a little, oh, there you go, more sugar. Sorry, I didn't mean to reduce the deal. Ah, give you some parts, just one part. Eh, some vegetables? No, okay. Take that back. Give me the part. Wait, do we have a good bargainer? What am I doing? What am I doing? We don't have a good bargainer. Okay, never mind, I apologize. In my initial, playthrough, we had a good bargainer, I apologize. I'm like freaking out over nothing. Okay, give me that, and what was I gonna give him? 9 sugar, and a bandage. Oh, wait, no, wait. 9, and then 1 bandage, and then we were gonna get your meat. Not all your meat, though. We can also get some components here. I'm gonna get all of his components and all of his wood, or some of it at least, and I'm gonna give him more sugar. Come on. Oh, damn, it's so close. How about if I take some of these off? There we go. Perfect deal. All right. Well, goodbye. This part of town is dangerous, but I'll try to come again. Good. Bye. Thank you. That's really good, actually. Now we have a good amount of food, and we have tons of stuff. You can go ahead and eat some of this, which is good. Anyway, guys, I think I'm going to end today's survival here. So I hope you all enjoyed it, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye.